Good afternoon. Well, there have been long lines at some of the mass vaccination hubs as the troubled rollout entered a new phase today. Over 50s eligible for the first time. But it wasn't all smooth sailing, with wait times blowing out, even for those with bookings. And staff at least one of the new hubs apparently were unaware that they were open to the public. The PM, meantime, has defended the India travel ban as well as the harsh penalties, conceding it's unpopular but necessary. And we'll have more on that for you in just a moment. But first today, Mark Santomartino is at the Royal Exhibition Building this afternoon. Mark, hello to you. Some people there have had to wait up to 2 hours.
Generally speaking, you could avoid those wait times if you had bookings, Alicia, but for anyone who was just rocking up and hoping to walk in and get their vaccination on the spot, yes, according to the website here at Melbourne's Royal Exhibition Building in Carlton, the wait time was up to 2 hours. It was up to 90 minutes at the Convention and Exhibition Centre, otherwise known as Jeff's Shed, and at the Heidelberg Repatriation Facility in Heidelberg, they actually stopped taking walk-ins simply because they were overwhelmed. That is the same location that we understand some people who had bookings actually had those delayed as a result of the influx of people wanting to get vaccinated. Obviously a massive milestone in our vaccination rollout to allow now everyone over the age of 50 to come forward. In many ways, shape or form, we expected this sort of turnout on day one. The challenge will be to keep this demand going. We know that the phone line for bookings was also overwhelmed, more than 8,000 calls just this morning alone. Meanwhile, we also heard about issues at Box Hill Hospital that you alluded to. We heard one person on Talkback Radio saying that she arrived and that the staff told her they weren't even aware that they were open to the public. That is a little bit different as a site, considering that they don't typically accept walk-ins. Now, the testing commander, Jerome Weimar, today said he was happy with the turnout and happy with the results, saying that all of these issues on day one can be considered just teething issues.
When you've got 2 million people to get through, you're going to see busy scenes like we're seeing today.
The people that we spoke to in these lines, Alicia, were just thankful that they could finally get this vaccine. Many of them had relatives overseas who were able to put it in perspective. One woman said that her relatives in India had to pay as much as $2,500 for a vaccine that they weren't sure was authentic. And another woman who has relatives over in the US, and we know the death toll of both of those countries, was just hopeful that she would be able to get back overseas to see them.
I don't think any of us could have imagined this. I'm just so excited.
To cope with this demand, Alicia, a 22nd mass vaccination hub will be opened in Melbourne tomorrow. That's at the Cranbourne Racecourse facility. And we've just found out as well from Greg Hunt this afternoon that the Commonwealth's advertising campaign to make sure everyone over the age of 50 understands that now is their time to book in will start tonight.
Okay, Mark Santomartino there, thank you. Well, a familiar face was among those to get the jab today. Nine News' Brett McLeod receiving his AstraZeneca vaccination. And we are going to hear about his experience from booking an appointment to pulling up his sleeve. That's coming up a little bit later on in the bulletin. Well, the federal government is coming under increasing pressure over its threat to jail Australians coming home from India. Emma LaRouche has the latest.
The government is standing by its decision, one that's been met with outrage and a bit of confusion over who's ultimately responsible for making it. As of today, any Australian attempting to enter the country from COVID-stricken India could face a 5-year jail term or a $60,000 fine, or both. It sparked concerns about issues of human rights, and some have called the decision racist. This morning, the country's chief medical officer said he didn't advise on legal matters after the government had yesterday handballed responsibility to medical experts. This led to the release of a letter from Professor Paul Kelly to the Health Minister recommending the Biosecurity Act make it an offence for a person to enter Australia if they've been in India over the past fortnight. Greg Hunt says the Chief Medical Officer's advice was very clear.
That is incorrect. These are the standard penalties that are enshrined in legislation. Interestingly, legislation that was passed unanimously.
The government, the minister, the Prime Minister has made this decision that he thinks Australians in India can either stay there for dead or go to jail.
But the government shouldn't be lying about health advice justifying these penalties on Australians who want to get home.
Cases in India have surged to above 400,000 a day, and more than 3,000 people died in one single day over the weekend. There are at least 9,000 Aussies there at the moment, just over 600 classed as vulnerable. The Prime Minister says he wants to get Australians out of India as soon as possible, but for now the flight ban will remain in place until May 15.
Masked thieves armed with an angle grinder have rammed their way into a McKinnon tool shop, costing the family business more than $20,000 in damage and stolen goods. Elizabeth Moss has more.
Around 5:30 this morning, three robbers chose this tool shop to target, but they had their work cut out for them as they forced their way into the store. Using a tyre lever, they tried to pry their way through the front doors. When that didn't work, they switched to an angle grinder, but still no luck. One robber throwing the tool at their own car window in frustration. Eventually, they used the black four-wheel drive to smash the doors open and ransack the store.
Three clowns, not knowing what they were doing, grinding pins open, between $10,000 to $20,000 worth of tools, which is all Makita stuff, and the till.
Triggering the store's security system, police were called, but as the thieves fled in the four-wheel drive, they were caught on camera hitting the police car, which was on its way. This is the second time the family business has been hit in 18 months. The owners, beyond frustrated.
It's knocked the front doors straight off the hinges, broke the whole shop front open. They were in there for about a minute and got about 10 grand's worth of gear then.
We've worked darn hard to, build up our business, and someone just comes in and thinks they can just take it. It's devastating.
This morning, a crime scene was set up as police try to track down the robbers. Police want anyone who witnessed the ram raid or who has CCTV footage that could help them to contact them immediately.
Wet cement has spilled across Peninsula Link, causing big problems for drivers heading south. A cement truck rolled just after the Golf Links Road on-ramp just before 2 p.m, spilling the load and forcing two lanes to close. The driver was checked over by paramedics at the scene. Well, more than $500,000 has been put through the pokies in a single day in one Melbourne council area, the most on record. Laura Turner joins me now with the details. Laura, which area are we talking about?
Alicia, it was Brimbank City Council, where residents were losing more than $475,000 a day, every day in the month of March. And that was an increase of $120,000 a day from the year before. This municipality includes suburbs like Sunshine, Albion, Brooklyn and St Albans. They are financially disadvantaged suburbs. And their council, the Brimbank City Council, says these losses are terribly frustrating because the council describes itself as a toothless tiger. It has no control over pokie regulation, no control over how many are opened in its suburbs, and no control over their opening hours as well. So they've joined an alliance campaigning the state government to step in with real action.
If you limit the opening hours from midnight till 10 a.m, they've got to be closed, you will literally save people's savings, hopes, maybe their lives. And the government simply hasn't done this. It is utterly irresponsible regulation going on by the state government here.
Alicia, in other hard-hit areas include Dandenong in Melbourne's southeast and Geelong as well. But in Brimbank, the council tells me that they have lost $1 billion in the past 10 years going down the drain in pokies losses.
Quite unbelievable. All right, Laura Turner there, thank you. Prince Harry has urged a crowd of thousands at a fundraising event in California to ensure no person or community is left behind when it comes to the COVID-19 vaccine rollout. Speaking at the Vax Live concert, the Duke of Sussex, who is co-chair of the event alongside his wife Meghan, called the vaccine a basic right for all.
We cannot rest or truly recover until there is fair distribution to every corner of the world.
The event hopes to raise awareness for the vaccination and to raise money to help the rollout across the world, and featured appearances by Jennifer Lopez as well as President Joe Biden. The concert will be broadcast next week.